Since the discovery of her relics in the catacombs of St. Priscilla in the early 1800s until our own time, St. Philomena has been the go-to saint for countless other saints. In moments of great difficulty, they have had turned with confidence to the young virgin martyr, that 13-year-old girl who defied an empire, who rejected the offer of a throne in order to swear allegiance to the kingdom of heaven. And that's the saint that we celebrate today. We celebrate a young girl who, when offered everything that this world had to offer, rejected the vanities of this world, proclaiming, "My kingdom is in heaven." We celebrate the feast of this child saint. We celebrate and honor this virgin martyr. We recognize that the church believes in miracles. One of the foundational principles of our faith, that we believe that God intervenes in our lives, that he is not some nameless, faceless force on the far side of the galaxy. We believe that God reaches in to touch and to change and to transform our lives when we turn to him with confident faith. And he particularly responds to us when we recognize and respond to the beauty of his grace at work in the lives of the saints. So many people will ask, why do we need to pray for the saints? Why should we foster devotion to them? What part do they play in our lives? When those questions are asked, we need to point to the creed, which we recite every Sunday. We believe in the communion of saints. What that means is, we believe that the men and women and children who have gone before us mark the sign of faith, are constantly interceding on our behalf for us. We believe that because of our baptism, our lives are interconnected, both the living and the dead. We believe that the saints who stand before the throne of God love us, care for us, and are praying for us constantly. But even more, we can understand the power of the intercession of the saints when we think about our own children. When a stranger comes up to us and tells us how beautiful our children are, or how well behaved, or how impressed they are by our children, doesn't that make a parent's heart glow? Don't we smile and look kindly upon that person? So it is with God, who is truly our Father. How well God delights in his people, but how much he delights in his saints. And when we approach God, when we venerate those saints, when we praise the Almighty Father for the gifts and graces which he has poured upon those saints, it is our way of saying, recognizing, and acknowledging what God has done in the life of that individual. And God responds with the same delight that we do when our children are praised. And God particularly delights, as we know from the Gospels, in the little children. For the kingdom of God is made of little children. That is why St. Philomena's prayers are so particularly powerful with God. For she is truly a child, a 13-year-old girl, who in her moment of testing was strengthened by God. But her prayers are heard, particularly because in her young and short life, she reflected those virtues that are most attractive and irresistible to God. Innocence, modesty, purity, courage, trust, hope, confidence. These are the virtues that are irresistible to our Heavenly Father. And as we honor St. Philomena this evening, as we ask for her intercession, these are the gifts that we must pray for ourselves most of all. Over and above all else, we should pray for innocence, modesty, chastity. We should pray for courage, hope, trust, confidence, generosity, faith. These are the virtues that will draw God to us and draw us to God. And these, of course, are the virtues that are so lacking in today's world. Why is St. Philomena so important in our lives today? Why has devotion to her made such a resurgence in recent years? First of all, she is the saint that will not die, no matter how much people might try to discourage devotion to her. She simply will not be outdone in hearing our prayers, responding to our needs. Those who discover devotion to her discover the joy of a communion of saints. They discover the joy of having a true friend in Christ. But God has raised up Philomena from the silence of the catacombs to the bright light of day. Devotion to her has flourished in our own time once again because she is the antidote to all that is ill in our modern world. To the cynicism and skepticism of our time, she brings the innocence of a child. To a world awash in pornography and impurity, she reminds us of the strength that comes through chastity, modesty, purity of body, and purity of heart. In a world filled with fear, she is a witness of courage, a courage that is born of faith. And it is her faithful witness, even in the face of death itself, that brings hope to so many hearts. And so we honor her today, and we call to mind her witness, her example, her presence, and her powerful intercession before the throne of God. We ask for that intercession. We ask for her intercession on our behalf, in our needs. We turn to our sister in Christ. As we thank God for the gifts and graces bestowed upon her, we ask for a share in those same graces and virtues. We ask for her presence, her friendship, in our home, in our families, in our relationships. We particularly ask for her blessing on our school and upon all our children, upon their families as we begin a new school year. And we remember, like countless saints before us, that when we are in need of a miracle, when we are in need of great help, when things are difficult and beyond our strength, we are not alone. Like so many saints before us, we can turn with confidence to St. Philomena, trusting in her powerful intercession before God. And so this evening we do just that. We ask for the answers to our prayers. For all those who would like to be anointed with the oil from her shrine in Munyana, for all those who have been making their invite you at this point to come forward and to stand around the foot of the altar from candelabra to candelabra so that you can receive the anointing if you are in need of healing, body, mind, and spirit. If you'd like to receive that anointing, we invite you to come forward at this time. Thank you. Solemn High Mass is the church's most solemn form of worship. This is as close to Rome as you can get without actually traveling across the Atlantic. So I want to thank you for participating in the Solemn Mass, for taking the time to worship God in this very, very special and solemn way. And as we conclude this evening, we will conclude with the blessing and veneration of the relic. If you would like to come forward to venerate the relic of St. Philomena, it is a very special relic. It is a first-class relic, which means it is a piece of her bone, particularly it is a part of her skull. And so we honor her by venerating her relic. Relics are enshrined in the altar of every Catholic church. In our own altar here at Cabrini, we have the relics of St. Maria Goretti and St. Francis Cabrini. But this evening, we pay homage by kissing the relic and acknowledging our relationship with the saints. And so you're invited to do that at the end of the celebration. If you'd like to come forward and venerate the relic, we'll do that at this time. And then after you venerate the relic, you are dismissed. I want to thank in a special way my brother priests who are here to help celebrate, Father Adam Travis and Father Ryan Humphreys, who took the role of deacon and sub-deacon, and then our seminarian, Andrew Flynn, who is with us this evening, and all of our servers here from Cabrini. We want to recognize and thank our organist, Tommy Meyer, and our scholar, who have traveled here from Natchitoches to be with us. And so we want to thank all of them for participating and for adding solemnity to our special celebration.